I have the pleasure of introducing another doctor, Dr. Larissa Chuprina. Dr. Larissa. As I mentioned, this whole initiative has four elements, right? It's positive psychology, adaptive leadership, self-directed learning, and this idea of the growth mindset. And what I love about Larissa is Larissa has a PhD and basically expertise in all these areas. So Larissa, I'm going to ask you a very specific question. Introduce yourself and then tell us, you did your thesis and there were three elements that came out of your thesis. This concept of adaptability and change. What lessons learned can you share with this group? We have a group of allies and champions on this call. What can you share about change, adaptability and change?
So thank you for the invitation and the opportunity to speak to and with such beautiful panel. And really, tears come to my eyes also, listening to these stories. Thank you for your legacy and for your contribution to the movement. And thank you, Tracy, for moving on with this movement. And I am so honored to be part of it. And I hope to leave my legacy too. I'm an international educator. I came to the United States more than 20 years ago as a Fulbright scholar. And my area of research was intercultural communication and education and business. My research that I did later as a doctoral, in the doctoral program at the University of Tennessee, allowed me to see some aspects that combine all the efforts and from psychological perspective, educational training. And it is, I found that one factor, resilience, is so important to be a good learner, to be a good leader, to adapt effectively to any change, including cross-cultural adaptability. It can be for people who immigrate to another country, who came to work temporarily, or to any cultural change like we are experiencing now. So I'm working now on a comprehensive program that I called Joyful Resilience, and to bridge the gap between immigrant workforce and employers, businesses, and organization to help both sides to understand each other, to come to the common ground of humanity, that all people want peace and happiness in their own way, but it is actually the same. To be recognized, to be heard, to be recognized who they are. I am also helping King County and some PR groups to be an ambassador to ethnic communities. And my dream is to create language of understanding so that the message could be delivered with the love and kindness, so that everybody see that they are taken care of, that the school system that I am helping now as an interpreter can change and be more receptive to people of different and various linguistic background.
I love that. What I love about your research, there were three specific things you talked about: grit, openness, and what were the three things?
That yes, you understanding remember? Self. So resilience, understanding self, what you really want, what makes your dream, what is more, what are your values, who you are, and your beliefs are also matter.
I love it.
So this is where individuals are part of the society, and each person can have this responsibility for self-growth and for contribution of talents, but you need to know yourself and what you are capable of. Yeah, and third, that. Openness and flexibility for changes and understanding cultural nuances, what is going on and how you can adapt and adjust without losing your cores and values, who you are.